all good. This is not going to be any great in-depth review of the 7D Mark II. There's plenty out there. It's not been in the market very long. In fact, I've not long just got mine, but obviously the review models have been out for some time. They've been given to plenty of professional photographers in faraway lands who have done remarkable things with them. So this is not going to be a full review of the 7D Mark II. What it will be, I hope, is a practical example of the camera and in action and the results it produces. As I said, I was lucky enough, I got to use it at Fort Canon in Germany, in Cologne. I got to test it. The thing that impressed me most was the AF, basically, how quick it was. Unfortunately, it didn't get enough time to go and shoot images because they wouldn't let you put cards in the camera to record, so I can't show you examples of that. This is what I hope to change tonight. Tonight I'm going to be shooting some Elite League ice hockey from the ice level, which is probably the most difficult place to do it because it relies on speed, the equipment you've got obviously, and how good your AF is. Now the AF functions in this camera are many and varied, and I suspect it's going to take someone who's shooting sports or any sort of moving action a little while probably to work out exactly what's best for them. Although they have pictograms of different sports, they've got things like someone playing football, tennis, this sort of thing. They don't always work quite as you possibly expect. Unless you start tweaking some of the settings, and as I said, the settings are quite varied. There's a lot of them, and in fact, for some people, I suspect, might be quite baffling to get fully to grips with it. But other than that, I said, camera's nice. I'm not particularly worried about the 10 frames a second or 12 frames a second or that sort of speed. I'm usually looking tops about 7. About 7 frames a second tends to work for the stuff that I do in ice hockey. And ice hockey being the fastest game on 2 feet, it's a good test for it. One of the things I'll say right off the bat is great camera, nice feel to it. It's got the same weather sealing properties as my normal camera, 1DX. So it feels very similar apart from the one thing I think you do need for this. I've not got particularly big hands, but this, the power grip, without a doubt, the power grip turns it in to a much greater beast. Feels a lot more natural for myself, probably because I'm using 1D cameras, but this is 100 times better, and for me really is a need for the camera itself. The only thing is, all that's available at the minute is the Canon product, and the price they're charging for it, I think, is excessive. Somewhere in the region of £250 for a grip, which probably the Chinese will manufacture and give you for about 30 quid very shortly. Just give them time to catch up. But as I said, the difference being it's got the same feel, got the same materials, and it's weatherproof to the same degree as the camera. So that's what you're paying for, as well as the Canon name. Same with the batteries, I'm quite sure that they'll catch up with the batteries, although the good thing in that regard is the old batteries still fit and still work, and that's what I'm using at the minute. One of the things I did notice was the charger. The new charger does not appear to charge the old batteries, or it certainly won't charge mine. The link just continually blinks. Sorry, the light just continually blinks. After a few seconds of putting it in, it looks as if it's going to start charging. Then we get continuous blinking light, so not so good. As I said, this is a rather short 24-70 lens I've got on it, but by the time you put on a 72-10 by 1.4 extender, then you really need that grip at the bottom. So what I'm hoping to do is obviously show you some images. So if you want, we published on my Facebook at some point tonight. The game finishes at probably clear for about 10 o'clock UK time, so a couple hours later images should be on my Facebook, and I'll put the link on my website as well for you to go and see. Facebook is just my name, George M. Monaghan, on Facebook, and I'm from Glasgow in Scotland. So if you'd like to see, have a look at some of the images, they'll be posted there to see what this gives. The lighting's not the best in ice hockey, and Brayhead, where we shoot the images, is actually quite good, but again, you're looking at shutter speeds that have got to be fast, obviously, to capture the action. So we'll see how it balances out. The 1D is excellent for it. Whether this has got the same low light capability, I'm not belonging finding out. So I'll let you know as we go along. So after a couple, I've got a game on Saturday night, got a game on Sunday night. So by the time Monday comes, I'll know exactly how fast, how good, and how useful this tool is. And that's what it is. It's a tool. So does it do the job? I'll let you know. See ya.